Morning children, today we are here in 10th class, unit 9 electrical and within that we are in electromotive force. In previous class, we have discussed about working of a battery, how a battery works depending upon potential difference. Now, next topic is about electromotive force. This electromotive force is denoted with capital E, which can be defined as work done by a chemical force. Here, force is doing one work. What is that force? Chemical force. To move negative ions from positive terminal to the top negative terminal. This is positive terminal and this is negative terminal. When we are connecting it to a source, what happens is uniform electric field will be set up throughout the conductor there, so that the nearby electrons attack towards positive terminal. So to take out the negative ions from this particular positive terminal, what else? Which will be doing work there? Battery will be doing work. Battery consisting of chemical energy, that is, chemical force will be applying upon negative ions, charges, negative ions, to drag it from positive terminal to the negative terminal. That phenomena is called as electromotive force. Work done on negative ions to move from positive terminal to the negative terminal is called, by applying one force, that force is called as what? Chemical force. It is called as electromotive force. When we are applying it to a source, automatically what happens? Electrons drift from negative terminal to positive terminal. Why? Drift means what? Change its direction. Before connecting to a source, all electrons will be moving randomly. As we are connecting to a source, due to applying of uniform electric field in one specified direction, exactly opposite to that one, electron drift moves, change its direction and moves from negative terminal to the positive terminal because of one force. What is that force? Fe I have given there. Fe is nothing but what? Electric force acting upon them. That is the first point what we have to keep them. At the same time, what happens there itself towards positive terminal? Negative ions will attack towards positive terminal. So what happens on negative ions? Equal amount of charge will move from where positive terminal to the negative terminal by acting terminals against which force? Fe force. Fe force is coming towards this side. Negative ions are moving towards the other side by acting one force. What is that force? Chemical force, which will be moving, negative ions will be moving from positive terminal to the negative terminal. It's exactly against electric force. Against electric force, because of that reason, Fc is acting, means what? Chemical force is acting in within the term, due to that reason, which from where this particular chemical force is producing? From a battery. Therefore, work is done by chemical force, that is Fc, we can give it up. And if you observe that itself, these chemical force as well as electrical force, both will have equal in magnitude. If I form a concept called as work done by the particular charged particles, work done is equal, according to energy, work done is equal to force into displacement. Here, which force is acting there? Fc force is acting. Means what? Chemical force. Length of this particular conductor is equal to how much are taken there? L. Therefore, Fc into L will give us total work done by that particular charge on negative ion to move from positive terminal to that of negative terminal. But also we know that chemical force is equal to that of, equal in magnitude to that of what? Electric force. Therefore, Fc is equal to Fe. Therefore, in place of Fe, eigenplace is about Fe also eigenplace it up, as both are equal in magnitude but acting against each other there. If I go for work done per unit charge, means what happened there? Fe into L by Q, which is equal to electromotive force. Generally, we can say that electromotive force is nothing but what? Work done by chemical force to move a unit positive charge, to move a unit positive charge from negative terminal to the positive terminal, a unit positive charge, as we got Fe here. Since Fe is equal to Fc, therefore what happened? A unit positive charge is moving from where to where? Negative terminal to the positive terminal within that particular battery. That is called as electromotive force. Units of electromotive force is what? It is measured with what? Volts. Summarizing potential difference, we have seen it up. Joule per coulomb is equal to nothing but what? Volt. And it is measured with one device. The device is called as what? Voltmeter. In what way we have to connect there itself? Parallel connection we have to connect within that particular component which are connecting in a circuit. Not only that, one general example, just we see it up. This electromotive force is nothing but what? Energy existing in a battery. If I am using torchlight there itself, to use torchlight, what I have to add? I have to place batteries inside. As I am switching on, continuously I am using for some months. After 1 month, what happens there itself? We will observe that as we switch on the battery, as we switch on a torch, we'll apply, we can see that the light of that particular torch, what it is giving, will be gradually decreases its intensity. It becomes very dim. By that we understood what we can understand, that battery had lost the energy, the chemical energy which is existing within that particular. So act of chemical force is lesser. It is less due to that reason, bulb is glowing with what light? Dim light, we can give it up. By this, we have completed a topic called as electromotive force, which is denoted with what? E. E is equal to, we can take it as nothing but what? Volt also, we can take it up. Both, that is about electromotive force. In next class, we'll go through with what? Differences between electromotive force as well as potential difference, we'll see it. Just now we have completed electromotive force. Now let me study differences between electromotive force. First point, when it comes to electromotive force is nothing but what? Work done by chemical force on negative ions to move from positive terminal to the negative terminal. That is nothing but what? Electromotive force. Whereas here, when it comes to potential difference, work done by electric force, Fe indicates electric force, on unit positive charge to move between two points, that is what? High potential as well as low potential. That is potential difference. Coming to second point, electromotive force is energy supplier to unit charge by cell. It is supplying energy to charge by cell. Whereas here, potential difference is nothing but what? It is a dissipated as unit charge passes through component. Displaces means what it is? It means internal energy is transforming from initial point to final point. That is called as dissipated. If you have seen there itself a conducting wire, it has high potential as well as low potential. From high potential to low potential, internally the energy which is transmitting, that is called as dissipated. That is regarding potential difference. Potential difference is nothing but what? Dissipated as unit charge passes through components, through various components, resistor, etc. So on, what else we can take up in the battery, in a circuit, through all those things it will be taken place. That is potential difference. When it comes to electromotive force is nothing but is called as a cause. Whereas potential difference is nothing but what? For this cause, the effect whatever is taking place. When it comes to electromotive force, is present even when there is no current supply. When there is no current supply to that one, but also electromotive force will be get present. But whereas potential difference absence of current. If current is not flowing, potential difference will be equal to zero. It remains always constant there itself, and it is always, this EMF is always greater than potential difference will be there. It varies continuously from one point to other point, depending upon the components called as resistance as well as current. So it varies continuously, and always potential difference will be lesser than electromotive force. Coming to next point, this electromotive force transmits inside as well as outside current of the cell. Inside current it will transmit simultaneously, and outer surface also of the conductor current will be get supplied. But whereas here when it comes to potential difference, it transfer current between two points only. One will be at high potential, other one will be at a low potential. Between those two points only, current supply can be taken place. It is independent of resistance as well as current, independent of parameters of components, what else are connecting within the circuit. Its formula is E, we can give it up. But whereas here, it depends upon resistance as well as current. Due to resistance varying and current, if resistance varies, current flowing in the circuit varies. If it is varying, obviously what happens, it varies continuously. Therefore, it is depending upon resistance as well as current flowing in the circuit. Formula is capital V. When it comes to this particular electromotive force, causes three different types of fields. One is electric field, other one is magnetic field, other one is gravitational field. But whereas here potential difference induces only one field, as we are connecting it to a circuit, electric field only it will be induced. These are some points, some important differences, differentiation between electromotive force as well as what we can call that itself potential difference. So children, try to analyze concept more attentively. Try to differentiate these two things and try to learn more concept, more about potential difference as well as electromotive force. Thank you children. In next class, we'll go with a lab activity, that is nothing but what it is, Ohm's law, we will derive it out. Thank you children.